Advanced Motion Control is a course targeted to control engineers who know how to tune a PID controller for a simple system, like one input, one output, and would like to extend that towards more complex systems. So if you have a system with multiple inputs and multiple outputs, it can be pretty challenging how to design motion controllers. That is the material we cover in this course. Many control design techniques have been developed for complex systems, so tools like H-affinity control, optimal control, robust control, and so on. But if you want to implement them on motion systems, things get very tricky. We will cover those techniques on day 4. In the first few days, we will extend basic motion control tuning ideas like PID tuning, but also Nyquist plots and Bode plots towards more complex systems. So we really extend the toolbox of control engineers that are already familiar with the industry towards the more complex situation. And this has major benefits for industry because the controllers that are designed are simple and can be implemented within standard industrial settings. The Advanced Motion Control course covers 5 full days. We expect from participants who join this course on advanced motion control that they have either followed the course on motion control tuning or have an equivalent knowledge of single input, single output controller tuning. What we then do on the first day is very briefly recap that knowledge and immediately use that knowledge and apply it to our multivariable system. Participants quickly notice that interaction is the thing that kills you in multivariable feedback design. We also make the first step on identifying the interaction terms using essentially identification tools that they are familiar with. On day 2, we then move on towards developing the useful theory for multivariable feedback design using essentially tools that extend motion control tuning ideas, so manual loop shaping of PID controllers and notches and so on. We give participants the basic ideas of stability theory, but also ways to analyze interaction, how much it hurts, and if it hurts, how to reduce it. Then on day 3, we're already halfway the course, we teach participants new identification techniques to very quickly identify interaction terms. And once they have that knowledge, they can quickly assess interaction and decide whether they can either do just standard motion control tuning based feedback design in cases that the interaction is small, or they can use that newly obtained multivariable frequency response function to reduce the interaction and then proceed with the basic PID tuning that they are familiar with. If that's insufficient, we also teach them a new approach on day 3, which is basically a way to sequentially design controllers for a multivariable system that's guaranteed to work in practice, but we also show the limitations of the approach. And this part is taught by an expert from industry who also shows how those techniques are implemented on a real-life industrial H-drive system, with all complications that occur in practical environments. So essentially what we do from day 1 till day 3 is build up a whole arsenal of tools that only increases the design complexity when it's needed and justified by the application at hand. So if the interaction is limited and can be reduced easily, of course, take that option and then just design a bunch of decoupled PID controllers that you're used to. In case the interaction is really severe, on day 4, we will move into optimal and model-based control design. So H-affinity optimal designs. And of course, anyone who hears about an optimal design methodology would say, if it's optimal, why not do the optimal design? Well, in practice, things are a bit more nuanced. These optimal designs, they essentially capture the performance of your system in a single number, a scalar criterion. But that scalar criterion has all the objectives you have at your system inside that number. And if it's small, it's good. But that means that all axes play a role in that one. So it's really hard to translate a complex control problem with multiple axes into a single objective function. And it will show you on the day 4, well, how you can do this in practice, but also that such an approach, if you want to do it in practice, has major limitations. And we believe it's important for practitioners to know the advantages and limitations of all the tools that are available. On day 5, we will move into feed-forward design for multivariable systems and already advanced feed-forward concepts such as snap feed-forward are covered on day 5. These are again taught by experts from industry who show you practical design procedures how to quickly do this in an industrial setting. Also on the last day, we will share with you the latest developments in frequency response identification. If you look at complex motion systems, they go to multiple axes, but even thermomechanical problems with thermal aspects in the loop. And then identification becomes really cumbersome and it takes a lot of time. With new techniques, we can really reduce measurement time, where in the past we would use multiple days for measurement, we can now do this in just a few seconds. And in the last day, we will share with you developments in frequency response identification that's very relevant to our industrial practice. So if you're already very familiar with motion control tuning for systems with a single input and a single output, this course essentially extends your knowledge towards systems with many inputs and many outputs with various levels of interaction. So essentially, you build up a whole arsenal of tools that increase in complexity when it's necessitated and justified by your control problem. So when you then go back towards the organization where you work at, you can easily assess for multiple systems what kind of tools would be most appropriate and immediately apply these in practice. So if you want to extend your knowledge on motion control tuning to our systems with a large number of inputs and outputs with various levels of interaction, reserve a spot at the next edition of Advanced Motion Control.